page 15, I don't know if you got to it, but it lists the 10 largest taxpayers in Massac County. And then at the bottom of that page, it shows the sales tax that we receive each year from 2012 to current. If you notice, in 2017, it's got a 2 asterisks next to it. It means that still need the sales tax that's been collected through March of this year. So you could take that number of times 4 and kind of get an idea of what to expect for the year if you wanted to. But as you can see, 2016, the sales tax was $944,000 collected. The year before was $916,000, and 2014 was $925,000. Page just shows new property that was picked up. Like Gary will pick up new property each year. I think 2013 was so high because that was originally probably when he got here, wasn't it? But what year did Gary hand? Do you know, Patrick?
But yeah, it seems about right. What were
13? I think he went out and he picked up a lot of new property. It hadn't been picked up in a long time. So that's why that was kind of high. And after that, it's just statistics of people that live in our county, what they make, what their average house is, things like that.
sample there, ain't there? Interesting.
You got a chance to look at it? I'm gonna make a motion to approve a certificate and file with Rule 15C2-12 of the Securities Exchange Act of 1934, connection with the offer and sale of general obligation debt certificates of Massac County, Illinois. I'll make a motion for that.
I'll second.
Call roll on that.
Gerald Childers?
Yes.
Jason Farmer?
Yes.
Jeff Weber?
Yes.
Motion carried.
Gerald, if you wouldn't mind sending two of those, and I'll send one off and get one.
You wanna fix that thing first, or?
Thanks. Can we discuss that?
We can discuss it, I'm gonna go on for today. On the way in, I was informed by the Mayor Metropolis that the City Council approved an extension of our intergovernmental agreement through the end of the year for them to provide assistance with the courthouse renovation project. They have approved an ordinance, and they have prepared a supplemental intergovernmental agreement. We'll need to put that on the agenda for next week and adopt it at that time.
Through the end of the calendar year?
That's right.
Of year, see?
It will be. If you, wouldn't mind put that on the agenda?
No, thank you.
Appreciate it. Anything else for me?
Mine.
You're good.
Thanks.
Good day.
Who's next, Ms. Taylor?
And friends.
What?
And friends.
And friends and company. This is National 4-H Week, starts October the 1st through the 7th, and we come yearly to ask for the commissioner's support. I have with me two 4-Hers that are also teen teachers, and I have Mr. Rob Mizell, who has become employee of U of I on October the 1st, and he is a program coordinator for Johnson and Pulaski. So now I only have Massac County, so, and that's, there's good things already happening. One of the big things we've got going on, we're getting ready to do some programming at MES. Hopefully, we're gonna get Tech Wizards Grant. We're 99% sure we're gonna get that. And we have Mr. Conkles on board with us, and what that will include, we will bring 3D printers, the boardroom machines, what's the other thing called? The what?
The silhouette.
The silhouette cutters. And our teen teachers are trained in those things, not me, they are. And they will do an after-school program one day a week, and there will be a teacher that will receive a stipend to supervise that. And those kids will be able to have access to those. The other thing is, we have two new clubs we'll be starting in Massac County. One will be in Brookport, we're working on that. And we have four teachers volunteering at MES to do an after-school science club. So So that's my update, and I'm going to turn it over to Keaton Reynolds and Lainey Overmark.
So on behalf of all of the county 4-H clubs, we thank you guys for your support in all our activities and everything we do.
I'm going to go ahead and read the proclamation first, let's sign. Massac County is proud to honor the University of Illinois Extension 4-H Youth Development Program for providing exceptional educational programs to the youth in our community and throughout Illinois. 4-H is a worthy program which seeks to provide a learning experience for the whole child by providing youth a greater sense of belonging, more independence, enhanced generosity, and mastery of a skill in an area they're choosing. 4-H reaches nearly 200,000 youth annually, ranging in age from 8 to 18, and whose club members perform countless hours of community service. 4-H relies heavily on the service of its more than 13,000 volunteers to give generously of their time, talents, energies, and resources to the youth of our community and Illinois. 4-H has a proud heritage whose alumni serve as positive role models in our nation. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I hereby designate October 1st through 17th, or through 7th, 2017 as National 4-H Week in our community. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
We need to make a motion to approve that, correct?
I'll make that motion to approve the
Proclamation.
Proclamation of October 1st through the 7th?
Yep.
2017.
I'll second that.
These two teams were lucky enough to go to Washington and serve on the state leadership team. Right now, we have another Massac County 4-H, went to Washington yesterday, and will be serving on the junior chef state leadership team. That's a pretty good deal.
Mm-hmm.
We've had three kids from Massac County.
Right. How long do they get to stay there?
Well, it's a quick trip.
Is it?
Everything we do is quick.
Yeah.
But they'll come back tomorrow. Yeah. But I think when Lainey and Keaton did, you all got to do pretty much everything.
You get to go with them a lot of times on the trips?
Our youth development educator goes.
Okay.
That's like the one teacher that, if we get the Tech Wizard grant, they will be taken to Washington for training.
They get to meet with our local reps and representatives.
We have it.
Yeah.
Good.
Thanks, sir.
Thanks a lot.
We're going to give you one and we're going to keep one.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Have a good day.
You too.
I'll go get a permission slip from Mr. Wilmore's for Christmas.
Pardon?
What was the girl called? I'm Lainey.
Lainey Overmark.
Is that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just trying to do, we started our district tours, trying to get around and meet everyone and let everybody know that I'm very humbled to be able to serve as the state rep and to do my best for the people. I don't claim to have all the answers. I know my area of expertise in nursing and nurse practitioner. I'm a small business owner. We have cattle. I'm a mother. But I certainly don't claim to have all the answers to our problems. We've got a lot of problems. But what I can offer you is I listen to people, and I look forward to working with each of you on any issues that you think I can help with. I'm in my clinic. I pride myself on listening to people, and if they come in with some complaint and some symptom, and I look at them, and I, you know, sometimes it's an easy diagnosis. I can say, "This is what you got." Other times, I'm honest with them, you know, I say, I have no idea what's going on with you, but what I can promise you is that I'm going to work with you to figure out what's going on. People appreciate that honesty, and that's what I try to bring, is just sincerity and honesty, and I'm a hard worker, so I'm going to do my best to represent the people as best I can. So, is there anything with you all that on top of your head, or anything that you like to?
Well, I just would say, you know, I've been a commissioner for 7 years.
Okay.
It's the first time the state reps came in here to our meeting. I know Brandon had never attended a meeting
Okay.
So we'll just say that.
Okay. Well, I want to be representative to all the people, so it's important to me to do that, so thank you.
Appreciate you coming down.
Yeah. No problem. We're going to meet with the school today, and what else we're going to do? We got a lot planned. We're in the school, did a lot of things, and we'll be back around too, but it was important to me to get into each county and meet with as many public officials as I could and introduce myself and let you know. I want to be very accessible. Almost all my patients have my cell phone number, which is good and bad, but I want to be very accessible because I think that's what a representative should be. So thank you for letting me introduce myself. I appreciate it. We'll stay for just a little while, and then we'll get to our next appointment. Thank you very much.
This one here.
Would you all buy a used car?
We're in the process. We're waiting on the check. I mean, we've got the insurance check. We just need that one.
What is it, like a car with 60,000 miles or something?
50.
50, yeah.
2014.
Are they having an auction there at the Highway Patrol in Missouri?
No, they just, their program over there is they, after 2 years, they take all their new cars off the road and replace them. Auction, or they don't auction them, I'll take that one for sale.
So at 15,000?
Yeah. I think it's $14,500.
That's to replace the one that we had the wreck?
Yes.
How many miles on that wreck car again?
142,000.
Did we just get about 7,000 or 8,000 out of it or something?
I think actually we got $8,500 out of it, so a bit more than what we thought we got. If we would put the car out here for auction at all, we'd probably got like 4.
Is this between the money from the insurance and contingency? Does that cover moving the radios and everything?
I'll have to put a little bit more with it, but that'll cover the car.
Okay.
And moving the radios is going to cost $500. All the lights and everything's still good on it, so let's move it from one car to the other.
Is that a Ford?
Dodge.
They don't have any Ford in your fleet now, do you?
The two oldest ones we got left are the ones that John drives in the jail car. We use the transport. It's green or gray or whatever.
Oh, okay. Is the blue car gone? Or is that what John's driving now?
No, he's got the green one.
He had a blue one forever, didn't he?
Pretty cool.
Yes.
Yeah. Did you see on the news last night, WSIM, I got it reported, I'll send it to you, but a couple counties now starting to charge $20 per inmate. They passed, the commissioners passed it. I think maybe Jackson County and another county. It was on Channel 3 News last night. That's something that, we've discussed that we really need to look into if possible, but it said that $20 a day for an inmate.
Talking about for restitution?
Yes. It says, because how the cost is getting, the cost of, it's just going up and up and up, it's really affecting us and getting less and less from the state.
Is that a new legislation or is this a county ordinance?
This was a county ordinance that was passed by the local commissioners. This was the second county that has passed it, so it's something we need to look into.
Who are the two that have?
Well, I'll send the article to you. I got it. I recorded it last night. It was on the 10 o'clock news. But at the very end, it did say, which that would be the out for a lot of people, it said if they have the means to pay the $20.
No, it's a problem. You can't get blood out of our car.
I know, but somehow they come up with the money to get out of jail to post bond, so I'm sure they're going to come up with that $20 if they can't get out. We got to make it tight and tough on them.
I'd be curious what money you could use, because a lot of them have money on the commissary account. Can you take that from them, or?
I don't know.
Or can you hold them if they don't come up with the money?
I'm going to go back and you know, look at the county, then we get a copy of what was passed in other counties, and then give it to Patrick and see what we can do. But it's something, today's times, that's just what it's going to.
Yeah, I guarantee the population's not going to go down.
No.
It's going to stay right where it's at the rest of the year.
I know, but, and sometimes you have people do petty things just to get in jail so we can pay for their dental care and other stuff and get air conditioning, you know, three hot meals a day, and we can't afford that. So we're going to have to do something.
Yeah, send it to me.
Anything else good going on?
That's about it this week.
Hey, where's everything on the four-wheeler leaving? Is he still,
He's been working on it today.
Okay, that's what I was, he was still investigating or if he rounded anybody up or what was going on?
It's sidetracked, was it about 4 days ago, we had one of the inmates shorted out one of the wires in the cell. We had to have Tommy Reed come down Friday night, early Saturday morning, over to some work. So we're in the process of charging that inmate with criminal damage to property and we'll assist restitution on it for that.
What'd he stick in there?
So he got some fingernail clippers and used it to straighten back some wires and shorted it out. Trying to light a cigarette.
So where does one get fingernail clippers in the jail?
That's a good question.
I assume that's under investigation, I hope it will.
So a lot of places you can hide things, you'd be surprised.
I'm sure I would be surprised. There's a lot of places they can hide things, not me, they.
No, sir.
Thank you.
See you later.
Yes.
Joe.
That's a good one.
Good, how are you?
Good.
Come on up, Joe. Joe, one of the county commissioners, I saw him at a meeting Tuesday night. He wants to know if you're interested in doing some oil and chipping for Polk County. Now, the way I understood him, they would haul the rock, all they need is, I guess, distribute the oil in that spreader. I think they're going to furnish the rock. Not all, I don't know. We didn't really get into it. He just wants to know if you'd be interested in doing that. In that time.
I mean, honestly, not really, but we barely got enough time to do all the stuff we got to do here.
I know.
Plus, it's a lot of use and wear and tear on a piece of equipment that's on
its
last leg anyway.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't mind helping somebody else. I mean, we do it from time to time, but, you know, we can't make money off of that kind of stuff. We can basically just recover our cost.
Yeah.
And that's it. So, is that for the South Polk District or
yes.
The North? South?
Well, I think South. He actually didn't say.
Well, it wasn't Ed Cunningham, was it?
No. It was Steve Hudson, I think his name is. He's a commissioner, but I don't know who he's talking about.
You're talking about, you didn't talk to the road commissioner, you talked
county
commissioner. Commissioner.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. I see.
What's Pope now? Is their staff low now? Are they?
I'd say two guys.
I have no idea. I mean, I don't know how I can ask Ed how many guys he's got, but I don't know how many South he's got. I think South only has one or two guys.
Yeah, well, yeah. The commissioner and a helper.
I think the one or two, yeah.
Who is the South Pope?
That one quit.
Yeah, he is.
The guy that was a worker there, I think, took the job.
The Stafford guy was the commissioner, and I guess, did he resign or did he?
Yeah, he quit. I can't thank that board. Might be better than something like that. I think he's been.
Step out, thanks so much.
Thank you, good to meet you.
Have a good day.
Thanks so much.
Were they interested in that next year, Darrell, or this year?
I guess next year. Actually, I don't think Joe, they have anybody. Well, they've been using, the guy from Marion. Short Brothers, or, I think they're out of business, aren't they?
E.T. Simon bought them out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is there anybody else up there?
One of the guy, I mean, one of the Short Brothers guys works for Southern Illinois Asphalt now. I was with him all summer on our paving job. Not all summer, but for 3 weeks or however long we took him to do it. But Alliant Asphalt, I think, is a lot of who people use to do contract oil and chipping. I mean, I'm sure they know that there in Polk County. They probably just want to try to get it done a little bit cheaper.
Well, I guess when they hire somebody, you know, they hold the rock and everything involved, you know, and at the end, it's just one check broke. And I think they're wanting to try to do some of it themselves. You know, haul the rock themselves, maybe, and save a little bit.
That'd be another question. Are they looking for somebody to distribute chips as well, or are they?
I don't think they have, I think they need that old truck and that.
It was just the friendly guy in here.
I'd say, and the labor. They want to haul the rock, the way I understand it.
So we're talking about an old guy, a guy driving an old truck, and then two guys on the chipper. You're talking about three of our crew.
Yeah.
I just don't see how we can do it, Darrell.
Well, I mean, that's fine.
Yeah.
That's up to you, so I'll just tell him it'll be 3 weeks before I see him, but I'll just tell him we just, I don't think he was talking about this year, maybe, so what?
No, yeah, I mean.
You know, if our equipment tears up and it's on our bounty to fix it, and, you know, it's just.
I mean, yeah, we would be able to charge them, you know, our labor fee per employee, and then we can charge labor fee for equipment according to the IDOT equipment rental rates. And that is supposed to cover, you know, wear and tear on the equipment, plus fuel, plus everything else, which I doubt it would recover that. I mean, if we blew up another motor in the distributor, it wouldn't even come close. So, and the chipper that we've got is always having problems, and it's on its last leg too. I mean, something can happen with that at any time.
Yeah. I'll tell them. How you coming on that? Pipe.
We got it done.
Got done?
Yeah, I mean, it's in. They're not just dressing up, but.
Fine.
I mean, we got it done, we got it in last Friday, and they were out there yesterday dressing up the sides, and I think we got to put some riff wrap on the ends and stuff like that. Looks really good. Sorry to what it was, I'd, you know, go take a look at it. I mean, I think it looks really good.
I'm sure it does.
It's definitely the widest point in that whole section of road.
Well, you didn't need to meet anybody there, I don't believe.
Of course it's not.
Rocky Branch Road.
Right there by Pat Parker's machine shop.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that was narrow.
Yep. Took that out and did some work on the streams coming in and out of it, and put a culvert in there and replaced the box structure that was there.
Did you have to rent the concrete breaker?
Yeah, we got it just one day. We got it all broke up one day.
Something like that cost for the county? What was it?
The whole project?
Yeah. The county.
We
had that whole thing, didn't we?
The pipe cost almost $9,000. The rock that we we bought to go on top of it and around it and everything else, probably another few $1,000, and renting the breaker a few hundred. So we're probably talking $12,000-$13,000 total.
Well, that means $300,000 bridge, or?
No, if we had a bridge that we had to replace it with, for, with a contract, it would probably been around $170,000, $160,000, $180,000, something like that.
Bad location there for anybody to do anything. Coming down that hill, you know, tying into all that. Wouldn't that have been hard to do?
The bridge, a bridge? Well, it wouldn't have been hard, it would have been a lot, it would have been some extra work. That hill going up on the west side, we would have had to do something with that to be able to even fit a bridge in there for the right lane, you know. We had to cut that down some and do some transition work into the driveway that's right there and so on. But it would have been, it wouldn't have been a cheap project, no.
No.
The culvert was tremendously, 10 times cheaper, more than 10 times cheaper.
Where'd you get that culvert? Thompson's, well, they're out of business.
Well, we bought it from Energy Culvert, and they represent Contech Construction Products, so we came from Cape, or, Sykeston or Cape Girardeau, where they had that place down there in Missouri.
Oh, didn't come from Energy?
Well, they don't,
come through there.
They don't manufacture pipe at Energy, they just sell it, you know.
Yeah.
The manufacturer was Contech Construction Products, and that, it came from their facility in southeast Missouri.
You know, I don't know if they bought, you know, Thompson used to be down there, you remember them?
Mm-hmm.
They sold that to somebody.
I believe Contech bought it down, but I don't know for sure. This letter I'm giving you is just it's just information. It's just something we have imparted on us again last week. I mean, the state of Illinois, in their cuts, took away a bunch more money from us.
She said you didn't bring that up when she was sitting.
It's the lady that took over Brandon's spot.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's unfortunate she left right before you mentioned this.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know why she left so quick. Maybe she knew I was going to say something.
She's like, that guy's got a look on his face. He's ready to say something.
I already put the hammer down. No, but I mean, they cut several programs, and the letter explained it all. This letter was passed down to the county engineers from IDOT. You know, basically, in a nutshell, budget cuts for the state of Illinois. They decided they had to cut some programs that they moved it from being general fund to road fund money. And because there's not enough road fund money to keep up what they were doing, they had to cut each program. They explained in the letter that these programs are not developed by state statute. So these are the ones they cut. And that county consolidated program is the only one out of a bunch of them that we really get money from anymore. We used to get needy township money back when Larry was still here, but they cut that out back then for us. And now they're cutting this again. They basically cut that county consolidated program by 50%, which that's a pretty big chunk of money for us. I mean, we were getting like $104,000 in that program per year, and now we're only going to be getting 52 or 51, whatever. So, as you can imagine, $50,000 less in our budget means a whole lot. That's however you want to look at it. That's 5 loads of oil, that's 1 employee, that's, you know.
It's a lot.
1,000.
5 loads of oil go a long way on tar and chip.
Well, we're only putting 10 down a year.
Yeah.
If we mm-hmm. totally took it out of that, that would be, okay, we're cutting our maintenance program in half. You know, I mean,
see this getting turned around, go in the other direction there, down the road?
They don't.
Yeah.
They said it just won't get worse.
Mm-hmm. That's what I suspect.
Because part of it explains in here, part of it is being used to pay back the bonds that the state borrowed money for state projects, and they're taking it out of local funds, pay it back, and they said it's only gonna get more.
To service the bonds is gonna be more than in the future than it is present.
It says, yeah, that the cost of covering the bond amounts will increase each year in an escalating fashion. So, if anything, it's gonna get worse. It's gonna be more cuts. I don't know how, you know, we were on an unsustainable path for years, and this is just speeding up the process, and that's what everybody's talking about, and firing emails back and forth and seeing what we can do about it.
Well, it's a shame you couldn't get some answers right now, that she just left.
Well, she wouldn't have any answers, but she could at least be aware.
Yeah.
She's dropping by the Metropolis Planning at 1:30, so if you have an extra copy.
Well, these guys don't want theirs.
Oh, you can, I'll let you go make a copy of this one later.
I can go over there and make a copy.
Do we get any good news?
Hey, I'm the biggest fan.
Gerald, and we already discussed that road out there, is it Driftwood Landing or
Speed Limit?
Yeah, and the curve or a school bus stop is headed or something. Did you bring it up in here or where?
Yeah. The guy on the corner there.
Yeah.
He said they were exceeding 55.
Well, they may be.
Well, pretty fast.
Pretty fast.
Down to there. And there was something else he was arguing, I was writing about. What was it?
The kids are.
Playing?
No, they can't. There's cars are driving fast, so fast down through there. I don't know whether the parents or the school bus driver told the kids to back up down that other road because they're afraid somebody gonna run off that road and run through a crowd of kids.
Yeah, that goes down to Driftwood there.
Is Driftwood the one where you turn left or?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what's the one when you turn off Chopper Road? What's the name of that road?
Riverview.
Riverview, okay. Yeah, right there at that intersection.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently the kids can't. Somebody's fearful for the kids even standing up there close to the intersection, which I guess the bus must just make that loop.
Probably did. See, I don't think there's any way to turn around back there.
Yeah, Driftwood is a dead end. I mean, yeah. There's no, I don't see how anyone can get up to that speed on that road. I mean,
no, but he's talking about, he lives right there on the corner.
Yeah. If you're going on Riverview 55 miles an hour, sure as can be, you're going to have to slam on the brakes once you get to that curb because
there's
a curb back there that's a lot tighter than that. I mean, you can't.
The curve I'm thinking about would be between the intersection and Joppa Road. There's like some S curves or something in there.
Are they
reverse on the south? Or?
Yeah, but towards the end, I mean, when you turn to go around the back where Driftwood is and then turn back to go towards Joppa Road again, those two curves are pretty tight. I mean, but there are some other tight curves. I mean, it's not a straight road anywhere you look down through there. It curves the whole entire way.
Do we have a school bus stop ahead sign around or?
Down there.
There's not one down. There's not any down there. I was just curious if there was any in the shop or anything. Just something interesting, guys. You want?
Miss Patton did put a deputy down there and said, see how fast they're going.
Yeah, it could be.
They're going over 55, and that's way too fast. Mm-hmm. 55 is too fast down through there. But that's the speed limit.
Well, there's always that portion of the law that says it's too fast for conditions. I mean, I don't know how you enforce that, but.
Yeah.
As I've said a million times, you can't sign everything this county to make it right.
No. I mean, and that's also local traffic. I mean, they know the school bus is stopping there.
I get pretty aggravated driving on Country Club Road because every single day people are on my rear end on that road and past me going, and I'm not talking just 55, 60 miles an hour. I'm talking 75, 80. You know, that just aggravates me to death. I mean, I don't, sometimes I put my lights on, you know, my warning lights, because I'm turning or pulling over or something like that, and it kind of, you know, maybe gets their attention a little bit, but it doesn't stop people from doing that.
Speaking of that, was there a wreck at that intersection again recently, the Country Club Road and Old Marion Road, I think over the weekend or something?
I didn't hear about it.
I heard there was a wreck there. How bad it was.
Kind of a bad spot.
Did you cut them bushes out at that intersection?
I don't know, Libby. I don't know if they got to that yet or not. I mean, they're out trimming trees right now and cutting trees, but I don't know if they got to that one yet or not.
It's, even in a car, I think it's hard to see to the west, though, if you're going north.
I just don't think I'll put that one as priority then.
I think he's good with whatever you need to do, the way it's up to me.
He's the one that kind of brought it up, wasn't he? To you? Or did somebody else say something to you?
Somebody had said something to one of my guys, and one of my guys said something to me, and I brought it up here.
Okay.
And Gerald asked.
Yeah, you live in all jobs. Folks, I think I'm gonna go get him a combine.
Combine?
Yep.
Are you county business?
Everybody in this county likes to eat, don't you?
Yeah, that's me.
You need an attorney a couple of times in your life, doctor a few times in your life? Need a farmer three times a day? And that's if you don't wanna drive anywhere or be naked.
Is everything going right out there?
It is. Going slow, but.
Yeah.
We're gonna make it.
Oh, yeah.
Don't have to.
No choice.
No choice. Been fun.
See you later.
Been real.
Well, it lasted.
Yep. Let's see here, Jeremy might be interested in this. The DOT is set up at Old Glen Restaurant on the corner. So be taking your illegal truck down toward Carroll.
Now, what restaurant was that?
Old Glen, is that be there at the intersection at the old truck stop or?
Yeah, I guess right on the right, you know, just one side right in Carroll. Now, it used to be half of that.
I'm thinking out there where 51.
Yeah.
Yeah.
37.
Whatever it is.
Yeah, they've been there before, I've seen them there.
Well, they was out yesterday too.
Was it?
Yep.
Where was that?
They was in Carroll early yesterday morning, and some point mid-morning, I went past Wookieville's, and one of the vehicles was backed up there in that gravel that they, railroad track. This stuff making a little river.
There you guys, be careful, Jim.
See y'all.
Yeah.
I will throw my trash.
The speaker last night was pretty good, wasn't it?
Yeah, he was.
It's hard for old Patrick to back that up.
Well, he wasn't lying, he definitely didn't either.
Thank you, sweet. Do you need one?
Oh, yes.
You are welcome. So this is the annual report plus the quarterly report that usually brings to you guys. And so he filled in a portion at the beginning of, I guess, May through June. And then I continued on beginning the week of July, first week of July through August. It's been a bit of a whirlwind, so I hope I remember everything that's been going on.
Anything specific about Massac County, anything you want to comment or talk about?
Well, right now, Starquest Academy currently has one student. And it looks like they may be getting about four more.
What is that?
That's the regional state school.
Okay.
Other than that, right now, I don't think there's anything specific.
Would you say we have one at Metropolis?
Currently, yes.
I thought it says nine here. I'm not looking at, oh.
You're looking at, well, the first portion of this report is the annual, and then at the back is for July 1 through August 31st.
Okay.
So for the year at StarQuest in Metropolis, so it would have been nine at the time, but for the year last year, they served 12. So nine at the time in school, there were nine students.
End of last school year? There's only one nine now?
Correct.
Okay, just wanted to make sure I was understanding correctly.
Which is good.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
We have hired a new teacher there because Jeremy Colley, I brought him up to Project Echo to be the principal. He's still overseeing StarQuest South as well. And we hired Jamie Clark to be a new teacher at StarQuest South. Okay. She's probably, I think this has been her first, last week was her first full week down here in Metropolis. Before that, we had her up at StarQuest and our StarQuest North location to train and learn more about the program and the grant.
Is Mike Worthing still do the truancy?
He retired, and you go to the back about truancy. That's okay. So the first portion of this is through June 30th.
Sure.
And then we'll pick up, and even if you just flip to the back
page, you'll see the back page is July 1st to present.
Correct. And so you'll see that Mr. Worthing retired, and we've hired Greg Garner. He is just starting this week.
So his name's not on here, right?
It's not.
Greg Garner.
Oh, I know. I typed it in there.
Huh? On the back page.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
There it is.
Oh, good. I knew I typed it in there.
Now you can't get another pass, Gerald. He's on there.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Gerald.
Like sure. Six. Okay. So, yes, we hired Greg Garner. Steve Carricker. He's from Johnson County. He's taking it with some drivers at Echo.
Okay.
Up in Johnson City. And then I took Jeremy Holly and put him at Echo. A couple people in here who are green shouldn't be green, but that's okay. It's just two. So as you're aware, I took over for Matt July 1st and then Mandy Horn, assistant superintendent.
Mm-hmm.
Before that, she had been professional development director last year.
Okay. She works the Williamson County office?
Mostly. We're kind of at both, all over the place, actually. But she's mostly out of the main office, yes.
Any new programs or anything else going on?
We do not have any new programs at this time.
How's funding been for you?
Well, once they pass the state funding bill for the schools, we're okay. The rest of the grants are going good. The CTEI grant, that dropped a bit, but that's mostly for Franklin County. It is only for Franklin County. And then another grant that we have for community prevention services, that grant also dropped. But again, for this new year, it's only for Franklin and Saline counties. So. And don't ask me how that works, that Saline isn't even part of our district, but I don't know. The CTEI, it's on the back page, it's the Franklin County Regional Delivery System. But right now, we have every grant that we've can possibly get through the state. Truancy dropped about $5,000 this year as well, and it's added two more counties, so.
Yeah, like, I was just looking on page 11 there, under Massac County.
Yep.
Says no individual letters have been sent out to students as of August 31st. That means, like,
Correct.
Nobody been in trouble enough to.
No, not yet. School hasn't been in session long enough. I'm sure that will jump. Next report.
Okay. And then it says their plans were made for truancy officers to visit individual schools. You all did that yet?
Yes, they have. Until we hired Mr. Garner, Colton Foster, our Williamson County truancy officer, has been servicing the schools down here. They have a meeting scheduled between all four of them. October 9th, I believe, so they can all stay on the same page, follow the same protocols, same communication with one another.
Yeah, fingerprinting service, 61. Who's that for, or what's it mean?
That is for a variety of people. So teachers, healthcare workers. It's for a variety, I'm going to add that into this. The ladies at the office were telling me how they were going to break it down into all these different services. I just thought it was for teachers, but it isn't. And so I don't believe it's for police officers. I think they have their own, but it's healthcare workers, anybody who may be working with children of any kind.
Just to make sure that.
Mm-hmm. Fingerprinting background check. And.
I didn't know if it was part of the school bus training that they had added down there.
School bus trainers, yes, but those are held with the state.
That's the only question I have.
How's the building holding up for you?
Well, when it rains, it floods, mostly in that front area. I keep a humidifier in there and fans, and if it's dry, I think it works okay.
Sounds like we need to go up on the rent. Gerald, what do you think? That's something we've been discussing.
Well.
Rent increase, mark that down.
Yeah, you might need to mark that off.
Got a lot of counties to visit today?
Well, I guess I got confused. I was just visiting Massac and Vienna today because you guys normally have your board meetings on the same day.
Okay.
And so when I got my email, I mistakenly thought that my 10 o'clock was in Vienna. So I came here first. I was sitting out there at 8:15. And as I'm scrolling through and really looking, I'm like, wait a minute, I'm in the wrong place. So then I
jumped in your car,
called it to Vienna to find out that it was yesterday. They had rescheduled, and I'm like, don't put that in there.
It's too late.
Yeah, I put my mouth shut. So anyway, I left the staff, and I'll call and make it to the next.
You're running for election, right?
I am.
Yeah, congratulations.
Yeah, thanks.
Get on some candy and some praise.
Yes, a couple. There's a lot going on right now.
Yes, busy time.
Most importantly, I just need to learn my job and do it well.
Anyone running against you?
Not that I'm aware of at this time, but it's early. So, are you the only one that has to campaign this time, run, or?
Yes. Well, me, the treasurer, and circuit clerk has to because she got appointed.
Okay.
So she's got to run this time. Mm-hmm. Jeff does, but he's not running. So there will be a commissioner seat opened up.
Okay. And should I leave him?
Yeah, he just left the other one.
Yeah, he just.
There you go. Just has a long meeting today.
Yeah.
What's going on? Any more questions?
Gerald, you got any questions for?
No, I'm good.
Okay, I try to keep the same format and what you're used to seeing, so. No surprises.
You going out to the schools today?
Consider.
Huh?
Well, I had considered it, but Mandy and I were wanting to visit them together and go over the needs assessment survey and talk to them about the SSOS grant in here and how we can service them, what services we can provide, and what it is they need, so we can make sure that we give them what they need, not just, you know, a general. So they've added 13 more service opportunities that we can give to schools as well, so that's nice.
How's Amanda?
He's doing all right.
Good.
Yeah. It's different. I mean, it, for me, coming from principal to this is completely different, and I think it's even different than being a superintendent of a school. So I feel like he's doing a lot more of what I was doing before. We kind of switched roles.
Yeah.
But I'm just glad he's nearby, so when I need something, I can ask him. He reminds me that this is due. I'm like,
nice to see you again.
All right.
All right.
I feel like I'm starting to get my footing, so I'll try to get down here more often.
Okay.
Okay, great. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Sounds good.
All right.
Thanks for coming.
Good to see you.
Any more bills for me?